A reading from Jonah. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, Get up, go to Nineveh, the great city, and proclaim it the message that I tell you. So Jonah sent out, went to Nineveh, according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days' walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk, and he cried out, 40 more days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, and everyone, great and small, put on a sackcloth. When God saw what they did, how they had turned from their evil ways, God changed his mind about the calamity that he had and would bring upon them, and he did not do it. Psalm 62. For God alone I wait in silence. Truly my hope is in God. God alone is my rock and my salvation, and my stronghold, so that I shall never be shaken. In God is my deliverance and my honor. God is my strong rock and my refuge. Put your trust in God always, O people. Pour out your hearts before the one who is our refuge. Those of high degree are but a fleeting breath. Those of a lowly state cannot be trusted. Placed on the scales together, they weigh even less than a breath. Put no trust in exhortation. In robbery, take no empty pride. Though wealth increase, set not your heart upon it. God has spoken once, twice I have heard it. The power belongs to God. Steadfast love belongs to you, O Lord, for you repay all according to their deeds. A reading from 1 Corinthians. Siblings, the appointed time has grown short. From now on, let even those who have wives be as though they have none, and those who mourn as though they were not mourning, and those who rejoice as though they are not rejoicing, and those who buy as they had no possessions, and those who deal with the world as though they have no dealings with it, from the present form of this world is passing away. As Jesus passed along the Sea of Galilee, he saw Simon and his brother Andrew casting a net into the sea, for they were fishermen. And Jesus said to them, Follow me, and I will make you fish for people. And immediately they left their nets and followed him. And he went a little farther. He saw James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who were in their boat, mending the nets. Immediately he called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the boat with the hired men, and followed him. In the nets of a kingdom, Jan wandered seat from seat on the bus, crossing state line from Michigan to Wisconsin. Bruce had sent her the ticket. The two met at the church youth convention. Now she was going to be his high school prom date. Here's how it happened. At the youth gathering during morning worship, the two held the same green hymn book. During the afternoon Bible studies, sitting cross-legged on the circle on the floor, she read compellingly from her little red leatherette Bible. For evening reflections, the prayers she pulled from her blue plastic packet of devotions swept the room. Bruce was bedazzled. That's why he bought the ticket. When Jan stepped off the bus, she shimmered, telling him how she had gone from seat to seat along Highway 2, saving souls, netting 14 converts on a colorful missionary journey. As delighted as Jan might have been, her proselytizing is not the kind of fishing for people Jesus was after when he was passing along the Sea of Galilee, calling oily fishermen to follow him. What shook Simon and Andrew, James and John, and countless women and men throughout the ages to immediately, impulsively give up their nets, quit mending, abandon boats, and leave families and homes behind? Jesus' wild, sea-changing challenge demands courage. It dares us into a way of living, a manner of seeing, and a risk of not knowing, but earnestly believing that when he asks us to step up, something more meaningful than all we have awaits us. Jesus, follow me, comes amid a lifetime of rigorous monotony, in which we are constantly casting nets to catch more of what never satisfies. Jesus, follow me, is an epiphany. It is an invitation not to save souls, but to be gathered and to gather the weak and despairing, to minister the ruined and abandoned, scared and starving, to show compassion to mean and unloving, and to embrace the great, greedy, proud, and demanding. All of this awaits us in the nets of the kingdom of God.